Now, let's learn more about DLBCL. For those who may be newly diagnosed, what is it?
Diffuse large B-cell lymphoma is a type of non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. So this is considered a blood cancer. Lymphomas are a cancer of the lymphocyte, which is one of the types of blood cells that form your immune system. So when you think about your nodes, these are your part of the cells that help fight different types of infection. So diffuse large B-cell lymphoma is one of the types of non-Hodgkin's lymphomas. It's aggressive and considered an aggressive form of lymphoma. And it's when you get a cancer of those lymph cells that often involves the lymph nodes, but can also involve bone marrow, blood cells, other sites outside of the lymph nodes.
Do we know what causes DLBCL?
For the most part, we don't know what causes diffuse large B-cell lymphoma. So most of the time, it's going to arise with patients not having risk factors. We know that age is the most common risk factor, with the median diagnosis of a patient in their 60s. Although we also know that diffuse large B-cell lymphoma, why it's more common to be diagnosed later in life, can occur across all the age spectrum. So you see this in, you know, pediatric, adolescent, young adults, and older adults. There are some causes. These represent more the minority of cases, but certain viruses, including HIV virus, can be associated with the development of lymphoma. Certain other medical conditions, like rheumatologic conditions, and some of the treatments for these can be associated. And then some chemical exposures. But in general, most of the time, we're not going to have an identified cause.
What are the symptoms?
It can look a little bit different for different patients. So because this is often a cancer, most of the time there'll be lymph node involvement. For some patients, they can actually feel, or somebody will see, a lymph node that grows. Most of the time when this occurs, it's going to be in the neck, under the armpits, or in the groin area. Patients can start to have symptoms from other sites of those lymph nodes growing or disease. So they can get pain or shortness of breath. Or they can have what's called B symptoms. So B symptoms are like inflammatory-like symptoms from the lymphoma. And these can include weight loss, so a rapid change in weight for no reason. Night sweats, so daily night sweats. We call them drenching night sweats. They often like soak the patients. They wake up the patient, they soak their clothes. Sometimes they soak the whole bed. And then fatigue, so extreme fatigue, not able to do your daily activities. And then occasional people will have cyclical fevers.
Are there different types of DLBCL?
So in general, diffuse large B-cell lymphoma, there's one major subtype. You can divide it into different pathological or molecular subtypes. So the type of where the cell develops lymphoma during the cell's development. There are different chromosomal abnormalities. So there are different categorizations, but in general, diffuse large B-cell lymphoma itself is considered, it's treated often the same, even with these different subtypes. So there are different subtypes, in general, they're all considered like a form of diffuse large B-cell lymphoma. Mm-hmm.
They're under this umbrella of DLBCL.
Yes. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Do patients usually get diagnosed after they experience some symptoms?
So because this is an aggressive lymphoma, there are a lot of patients will have symptoms with this, and that's how they'll present, be it either noticing the lymph nodes, having the B symptoms, or having pain, or other abnormalities from the lymphoma progressing. Occasionally, whereas indolent lymphomas more, commonly are found kind of incidentally. Occasionally, that'll be the case with these, but I would say, a fair number of patients have some sort of symptom or something that brings them to medical attention.
Mm-hmm. How does DLBCL progress?
So, there's different as far as there's more aggressive and less aggressive. So some patients can develop symptoms really over days to weeks, whereas some patients are more weeks to months. Mm-hmm.